or the Japanese.
Yeah. Oh, we have a Korean battle here. We have UYU's Jeondding versus unsponsored JDCR.
He's not unsponsored.
He's not?
He's a OGN.
No, that's over.
It's over? Well, he's unsponsored there. That was a one?
It was 1 month.
What kind of 1 month sponsor is this, man? Sponsor me for a month.
I want a 1 month sponsorship. Let me know. Who should we represent?
But these guys traveled here together, and like you, they got stuck in the airport.
Yeah, man, that was rough.
They didn't get interrogated like the Pakistani players, but they got hit by the typhoon.
You know what? It's because they look like us.
That's it.
Oh, you can't say anything because you're not Asian? Oh, my bad.
They're talking here. I don't know. John's yelling at him. Where is this coming from?
The background noise is the production team laughing.
I mean the players. Where did the players come from? They were in Europe or something before?
They were both in Korea. JDCR went home after. Where was he?
They've been on like a world tour recently.
He was in Chicago, and he won the dojo event there. And Jeondding was in Berlin, where he beat Super Akuma and said, just backdash.
Just backdash, bro. But here we go. These guys traveling together from Korea.
Yeah, man.
JDCR said he was home for 1 day, though. He's like, I was home for 1 day to rest, and he's on your schedule, just traveling around.
Yeah, he's been going to a lot of events. And, you know, he stayed in the U.S. for a few weeks, surfing on Sejam's couch.
Stream Monsters, if you're watching, you need a place to crash, just hit up Sejam. He'll let anybody stay with him for free.
Yeah, all you got to do is sub.
Actually, don't even hit up. Just show up at his house.
Just show up.
Knock on the door and be like, Gina told me. Gina sent me here. But here we go. JDCR going with
That's true. He's home now. He never leaves. Sejam, he likes to stay home and stream.
Full-time Twitch streamer.
Yep.
JDCR been going almost. Actually, yesterday I only saw Heihachi.
Yeah, it was Heihachi.
He's been running the tour early. He's been playing almost exclusively Armor King, and now he's back on his boy Sergei.
Sergei is really strong in season 3. Not only does he have the benefit of the wall carry like a lot of other characters, he has probably the most ridiculous wall bounce.
Yeah, the wall bounce right there, the wall standing move.
Yeah, wall standing 1-3-13 frames and pure hatred.
That was great spacing from JDCR. Caught out the spring kick, went for the crumple punish, right? The crouch dash one, but for some reason,
He got him ducking there. Look at that.
For some reason, didn't connect, and Jeondding.
You know, this is a smart pick too, Dragunov. In this matchup, at least, he has a lot of things that can kind of restrict what Eddie's able to do or what he has the potential to do. But I wouldn't be surprised if he decided to pick Heihachi later on.
Gotta lose first, though.
Gotta lose first. Yeah. Right now, Jeondding does have the lead, though. Gets the float out of there, not able to follow up with more damage.
Jeondding dancing right now. Getting started, running too. Yeah.
JDCR has kind of changed his playstyle. I don't know if you've been watching him lately. He's been going to Wednesday night fights. He's starting to implement some YOLO American style.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah.
He's been rubbing off?
He's been rubbing something.
Feeling himself a bit too hard there. Just trying to go for the bar fight. Get off.
Yeah, he's been playing with speed kicks and running black. He's even been using Kazumi. We lost him.
Yeah, he's gone. But there again, JDCR in range. Doesn't spend anything. Jeondding closing out 2-0. Knife again. So far, I don't think a single knife's land. Jeondding's got a good read on when JDCR wants to go low.
Yeah. And the thing is, the big tell here is he's been getting a lot of launches. Oh my god, let's go. And the readjust.
Like I said, he said stop down to it, man. I know you're sitting down too, but not against me. I came from Europe. I trained in Berlin.
Yeah.
Oh, he
missed it. Doesn't matter. Yeah. He has a huge lead here. There's no way JDCR is that good, right? There's no way.
Yeah,
all right, cool. It didn't work.
Trying to curse him. But yeah, season 3 Tekken, man. Very high damage game.
That was
needed one hit to the wall, and then one mix, so that would have been it.
It was a slow and grueling 3-0, though.
Jeondding.
He's sticking to it.
He's talking to himself. Sergei. He's thinking of where's he want to go. Uh-oh. Jeondding. JDCR's not having any of this. No shenanigans, no antics. Leave me alone. This looks like when I was in high school, man. The little nerdy JDCR, the Chad Jeondding bullying him at the stage select.
Damn jocks. All right, just so you guys know, Hajir Metal ended up eliminating Pekos from the tournament. Taku eliminating Keisuke. Kokuma eliminated Rongshu.
Okay.
And Tsubumi beat Cherry Berry Mango.
Korea eliminating Korea. Tsubumi from Japan beating Cherry Berry from Korea. Okay. Hajir Metal. Man, Pekos, that's rough. Start day off on winners and go 0-2. Pekos can't be happy about that. Top 16 of winners, man. I can't wait for that. I want to just. Can we get to the Pakistani players again, man? I just want to watch them go all the way. When this is done, well, we're going to go to top 16 winners. Yeah, are we going to break FARP or what?
I don't know. I feel like I don't want to break, man.
I don't want to break.
Let's keep it going.
Como estas? fight. But yeah, so JDCR unable to get around in the first game against Johnny D. He got bullied in the character select. Jeondding's feeling himself right now. What are you going to mix up? And yeah, of course, JDCR locking with Dragunov. It's first two, so he cannot change. 1-2. The knives, that down two, right? That chopping low, key part of Dragunov's game, but been absolutely ineffective here so far. JDCR kind of sealed it already, right? Jeondding looks like, oh, spring kick, block, running to his smite there. Do it again, do one more. Stay going for the strings, and now the hammer time for the plus frames. Now he finally connects, and there we go. Floated him out of the relax, like you said.
Oh, the sidewall suddenly got in the way, not able to capitalize with more damage. Let's see what he does. What's the mix-up?
Mid. No,
oh
nothing.
My goodness.
What
the interrupt.
Hell? Wait, what
he
happened?
Knew. He went for the wall standing one plus two after the down back 3-4. He knew that there was a gap to be able to do something afterwards.
What did Jason, was that shoulder?
It looked like wall standing one plus two.
Damn, just disappeared. His life bar just melted. Cartwheel whiff. JDCR just wall standing four punish. Get out of there. Get off the ground, man. Stand up and fight like a man. Low parrot.
And he should be able to get the wall here. Let's see what he does with it. The delay, the flip over.
Hammer time again. Little backdash coming from Jeondding, making a whiff, but not ready with the punish.
This is tough, too, because, you know, Eddie has such a hard time sidestepping against a lot of the best tools. That, man, look at that damage. Yeah.
Wall bounce, and then boom.
But, dun-dun!
Yeah, mid that time, trades. This time, Jeondding the one with the life lead, so he's the one who survives. Gets the round on the board. I want to say usually, especially Jeondding, he hasn't been as dominant as he was. You know, he was winning a lot of events last year.
Last year he was number two points wise.
Yeah, I think this year he's really, really struggling. And, you know, JDCR traditionally beats him, I would say. So Jeondding must be feeling good right now.
Yeah, I mean, traditionally JDCR beats most people, right? And Jeondding would be no exception. Sidewall, son, let's see what you got.
Nothing. Jeondding's backing away, trying to reset the neutral here. JDCR in rage. Hasn't shown the rage drive yet, though. There. Finally brings it out.
Oh, oy! He went for it. But nice option there from Jeondding, able to mitigate the damage potential.
The mix. What's he going to do? Went low. Guaranteed damage, but not enough to kill. Big whiff right there from JDCR. Round four. Jeondding down. Match point.
Jeondding could take this. This would be huge because, again, this is elimination.
Yep. This is the loser's bracket right now. I know UIU fans are watching from around the world.
Oh, the running three gets that big chunk of damage. Right now, JDCR is going to have to pull out something. Ooh, instant. Knife. That's not a knife.
This is a knife. Last thing for interrupting again. His little pokes are adding up. Jeondding does have rage.
Oh, this is. Oh, man. I got hit by it.
Yeah, there we go. Close out the down four. JDCR, one round away from tying up a game apiece. Jeondding definitely does not want to go to game three, though.
Oh, hey. The power crush. He was waiting to use that.
Uh-oh, Crowd's Ash 1, got the crumble, but yeah, kind of weird angle.
Keeps him there. It's unfortunate. That's been happening to him a lot on this stage.
Down a hit, going to get the float.
Down 2-3, yes. Gets
unscaled
the guarantee.
Ender.
Oh, what are you doing?
Another knife's coming out. JDCR back to the wall, but he's fighting his way out. Here we go.
Yeah, Jeondding was trying to crush it there with a 4-4.
One more poke. All right, first one to rage JDCR. What's he going to do? Does he have rage drive? Is he going to bring it out again? Jeondding with Rage Drive 2. Here's the mix.
Do something.
Oh, it went low, but it wins. What the hell?
What's going on?
Get off. One plus two. We're scrambling now. One knife. Low poke. One more will do it for Jeondding. JDCR needs two pokes.
Oh, hey. And the wild standing four to beat the low jab attempt.
Oh,
look at him. Oh, my
no.
God. He just lizard licked him.
He's going to give him a wedgie. Shove his head in the toilet. Man.
Get out of here, nerd.
Woo! Talking smack. This is what happens, guys. Ooh. My man is roided up, man. He's
man, JDCR is going to rip off his shirt and he's going to flex on him. Oh, my God.
But yeah, with that, JDCR eliminated, not even in top 16, right? So he drowned.